Okay, good morning. Hello, everyone, and welcome back. Today we're going to do some Higurashi today. I'm still working on some levels. I want to get the party up to like 60 before I try again on that boss in Ch.6 Odyssey 2. So I'm going to still be working on that. I got 3 more kills that are still in the high, in like the high 50s. So I still gotta grind a bit for them. I think once they're in the 60s, I think it'll be a better position to move forward with them. And I didn't really feel like doing Slay the Spire. And like I said, I do want to try and invest a little bit extra time to try and walk along the final ends of this. So I figured that and Leo would not be able to join us for the next several Fridays for a while. So, and he really wanted to see this crazy, amazing scene that he's just dying to see my reaction to. Still so confused about... Yeah, they're still there. Yeah, those were, like, fucking weird, and I did not remember those being there in any other tip thing. Like, I mean, usually when I take a break, I double-check just to make sure, like, I did do all the tips right yet. So that seemed really fucking weird to me. Anyway, let's move on, see what happens. So she's freaking out that they're here to do something. You know, now I think about it, you know, they hinted at, like, them cutting trees in that area, and that never actually came up. I think maybe that was just to freak us out. Oh, she didn't even take her bag. Oh, deal. I have a bad feeling about this. I just don't know what to think about. Oh no, everyone died, so... Honestly, I'm surprised how easy she killed that guy, though. Hell, I'm surprised they even gave him Killjoy, actually. Thank you. Is that really the case, though? But she gets killed. That's probably, at this point, regardless of whatever theory we go with, she dies. So if the whole theory here they have in the end, regardless of what path you want to go, is that they're trying to recreate the ritual. That doesn't make sense when she dies. So wait, so you know, the fact that it wasn't a volcanic gas might explain how the MC survived. Because remember, the thought process was it was a volcanic gas that's heavy. So it would go down. So it should have filled the area the main character was knocked out in, but it didn't. It just continued on and murdered everyone in the village, supposedly by suffocation. Now, if we're going to go with the theory that the volcanic gas was something else, is perhaps related to this. Then that would mean, you know, anything could be possible. It could have been any kind of weighted gas that could have just went over. So I get my glasses. I have to fix that. Ah, damn it. I really need new pale glasses, bad. Holy shit. Oh my goodness. Thank you. So what, is he gonna comment on the money missing, or? That's pretty quick of him to notice that. Oh no. Oh, Lord. A second. Do you? Oh no. Now the police are going to investigate those two. That's cool. Why would she come back here? So the bodies are gone again. That, why would they do that though? Oh no. I mean, you're just a child. What the fuck do they have to worry about? So there's stuff she hasn't told us yet. this is... I just don't even know what to believe and what to think is just delusions. See, now she's just questioning everything. This is so weighing too much. She's just questioning everything. And be fair, I have that same problem now. Okay. Some trust. Now, here's an interesting question. Let's say we go on the theory they are after the scrapbooks. We know in 20 years the scrapbook's gonna be in a detective's hand. Oh, excuse me. In 20 years from now, this book is gonna be in a detective's hand. So if they were after the scrapbook, they failed. Somehow it did not ever go into their hands. Well, I'm doing this as a fable for Leo. So Leo wants to see this scene. Like, he says chapter 6 is his favorite. And he wants to see my reaction to this scene. Next Friday, he's going to be doing training. So he won't be able to catch next Friday or next few Fridays. So, seeing I don't have Etra Odyssey 2's party leveled up to where I would like to continue forward a little bit more. Three of the characters are still in their 50s. I'd like to get them a little higher, at least in their 60s. And I didn't really feel like doing Slay the Spire, so I figured why not just continue chapter 6. We can probably get 6 done, and then we'll have only 2 chapters left. So I'm assuming she's talking about what they talked about in the future. But the story is definitely getting interesting, though. He's buying it. Wow, he's actually buying it. So he's gonna try and look for legal. Something odd. What did they find odd about her death? I don't think they've ever commented on anything additional aside from she wasn't recognizable. I believe that was something they said, but other than that. And there was a similar situation to this, the end of chapter 2. Both sisters were dead, and yet one of them killed me. And then there's the fact that the uncle was missing. And then we have two dead bodies that are also missing in this. So, are we even including zombies in this now? Are they like body SWAT? Are they like stealing people's identities or something? Okay, so this is introducing new ideas. So let's go with the legit. We don't know what she's talking about quite yet, but let's say that Norris really was dead 24 hours before the festival. So she was already dead the previous day, yet she was at the festival. What weird scenarios could contribute this? Obviously, a lot of this would be sci-fi stuff. Body swappers, stolen identity, doppelgangers. But with some of the weird stuff we got recently, I'm wondering if perhaps, what if perhaps somehow other versions of your actual self from other worlds were like crossing over somehow? Like maybe it really was her, just from a different version of the town. And when you think about it, that could go with demon away theories. Because, like, in chapter one, we never found a body. So let's say in chapter one, her quote unquote demon away, she crossed over to a different version of the world. And then ended up at the festival in that world. But she was actually dead, like the version of all that world was dead. Oh. Is it a misunderstanding? She said she wanted to see him, and you tell me that. You telling me this whole like, you telling me the whole thing's happening because she wanted to see him, and like, I thought it was weird that Neville came back up, like he never came to see her or anything. Well, he really believed the story, that's for sure. Oh shit. He really arrest the people parked? Oh man, he's really taking this seriously. He's really taking it seriously. So yeah, this is just all a misunderstanding. Oh my goodness. And now they're about to get arrested, and oh my goodness, this is gonna get real fucked up. Oh, what in the fuck? So what? So everyone else is going to think it's about the corpses, and she and the police think it's about a conspiracy. There's literally two plot points literally conflicting each other happening at one time. What in the fuck is going on? So she did. Oh my goodness. So she did actually take him, but the. Oh. Oh my goodness, what the... It's all a gigantic misunderstanding. This is gonna end really badly though. Like, I feel like somehow this is gonna cause like a giant fucking war between the police and gangsters. Oh my goodness. She just, it should be the sister then. The head honcho. Cause she just admitted to moving the bodies. Anyone else telling the main character that would be outrageous. This is insane. So I don't know if this is what you were talking about, Leo, but so. The head honcho, not the twin. But then again, considering chapter 5, I guess that also... we talk about real identity or the identity they were tattooed with? But anyway... So this is crazy. So... One side thinks there's a mass conspiracy happening and the police are on that side. And the other side... thinks the police are trying to go after him. Why the police think the gangsters are going... What the fuck is going on? So, like, we're sitting here like, oh, man, why are the police after him? I don't understand. And she's like, with the police, like, I don't really understand why they're after me other than the scrapbook. What could it possibly be anything else? And they're just trying... The whole reason they've been looking for her, it was just to fucking ask her about what she wanted to hand the dude, the bodyguard dude. Like... It's like, holy shit. But, you know, then that makes me wonder, like... That kind of makes you, like, makes the parallels to what happened in Chapter 1 confusing then. Because, I mean, the villagers were very clearly attacking the main character at the end of Chapter 1. There's no way that was a misunderstanding in Chapter 1, so... Oh my gosh, this is all a mess. So yeah, see, and we just found, oh my gosh. They think the police the enemy. She and the police think they're the enemy. Like, and I bet the main character lets out that he told her about shit, and like, and she's gonna freak out and be like, "You betrayed me to my enemies." But then, so we're basically questioning everything that matches up with the whole parasite theory, or whether it's all just everyone losing their fucking minds. And then there's the whole thing she talked about. So when she was talking to the officer mentioned that the Norse, the forensic team said she had been dead for 24 hours, which meant she was dead before the festival, but she was at the festival. And she said that it matched up with the notes. There's something that we haven't been told that's in her notes that makes that somehow make sense. I want to know more about that. Well, at least the dead corpses that they buried isn't a part of whatever the fuck is happening. At least I don't have to worry about them being zombies. Oh no. And that's probably gonna cause problems on the other end, I bet. What in the fuck is going on, man? Leo's a big simp. Are we talking about the real one or the fake one? See, again, that goes with the whole chapter 5 thing. We going with the tattoo naming or the non-tattoo naming? I guess the both naming or the tattoo naming? And the question is, assuming she doesn't betray us, hey, I'm just saying, you know, because I mean, we know that they've actually body swapped, they are a prince and a popo situation. This is all going to go down so horribly wrong. We got police and gangsters that basically think the other party is harming a friend And they're not going to take the situation lightly like it. The twin sister is just hanging around in the house going like, I wonder what she did to get fucking wanted. This is somehow all gonna fucking bite everyone in the ass somehow. Well, so he thinks. You know, his parents still have not been... I tell you, this guy is crazy with avatars. Oh, I always know something. Like, we have police and gangsters that think a friend's in danger and the other is causing that danger. And this is all going to fucking just turn into some hella bloodshed or something. While all of this is going on, something is true. Something is happening. Something is wrong. And that is definitely going to happen regardless of whatever of this crazy shit is true or not. What in the fuck is even going on anymore? It's just... The world is losing its mind here. Oh my goodness. It fucking was. Oh my goodness, so They were, so I got to see tips that I wasn't actually supposed to see. What the fuck? Why are there tips unlocked that shouldn't be unlocked yet? What the fuck? So yeah, so I just got a bunch of shit I shouldn't have even known about. Well, fuck. So you're right, it was a fucking weird bug. That's... I don't know, like, I mean, on one hand, it gave me a bunch of bizarre shit to think about. I mean, but on the other hand, that means I was unnaturally given information that I wasn't supposed to know quite yet. So I don't know if that necessarily was absolutely horrible or not. So I mean, you could argue it was an interesting way of going about, or just bizarre, but that's... Okay, so note to self. Assuming this bug exists in any other chapters, don't click view all tips. Noted. I will also have to test that. Like... when I, like, maybe you'll try to Google, see if that happened to anyone else. I don't know if that's just some bizarre thing or something. I don't know. Very strange, but...